As we are building the electricity system of the future, one of the biggest questions is what on earth is it going to look like? This can be a different combination of power plants like wind farms, solar farms, hydro, natural gas, nuclear, but also a more overlooked part of the electric system is the transmission line network. So all of those power lines that transport electricity from the power plant to our households. One of my students, Lauren Janicke, has been looking into how the inefficiencies on the transmission and distribution network actually impact how much extra electricity we need to get from all these power plants. This collaboration between the University of Maryland, Johns Hopkins, and Carnegie Mellon University is asking the question of, if we make our power systems more efficient, meaning the transmission lines have less electricity losses, how is that going to impact the amount of power plants that we need to build?
So I've been working with Destenie to quantify air pollution emissions from the transmission distribution system, because when you want to get 1 kilowatt hour of energy to a consumer, you actually need to generate more than that at the power plant because of losses that occurred on the transmission lines from things like heat loss or electricity theft or inaccurate billing. So we are looking at different geographical regions to consider how different policies would be able to enact the most reductions in emissions. So we found that it makes more sense to focus on areas that are smaller, because then you can have more of a focus on the individual lines that would need to be fixed while focusing on areas that have already either more losses or higher emission intensities from the power plants. And so with that focus, you can make more reductions in the emissions.
One of the things that we have concluded is that making these transmission and distribution networks more efficient would lead to less capacity needs on solar and wind farms, meaning we would have to build less, which is great because that means that we don't need to spend as much money, and eventually we'll be able to reach the low-cost electricity future that we've all been hoping for.